This review is going to be on Zoya's nail polish remover, Remove Plus. The bottle feels really velvety, just like the fabric, soft and velvety. So it's really nice feeling. That's it right there. The bottle, and just comparing it to regular acetone polish. If you're curious, on the nail is Essie's punchy pink. That's the neon pink color that I did a review on. This is going on 4 days of wear. It started to chip yesterday, so it's not long wearing at all, even with a base coat and top coat. But if you're going out for a special event, if you're looking for something that it's attention getting, this would be it. I had to patch it up there. And I also had to patch it up there as well. So there's the color. This is kind of like a Clinique, where you unlock it, and the nail polish is supposed to pump out of there. It does. Close it, lock it. Smell is all right. There's that finger. You're supposed to hold it to the nail polish for a little bit, just to let it soak in and loosen up the polish. Hope you guys are swinging. Hope you guys are seeing this okay. First time on this tripod. So nails aren't dry. Skin isn't that dry. Now I'll try it with the regular polish. So, there we are. I'll keep going. go into the other hands. So I'm gonna clean the undernail now. This is with the regular acetone polish. Oops. Don't mean to flip you there. But I guess I don't have a choice, do I? Clean, clean. Oh, this one's tricky to do. Alright, so we'll be getting these, okay? So the difference that I can tell is this side with the Zoya polish remover. Definitely feels softer compared to this other hand that was the pure acetone. The edges feel rough and dry, and I don't know if you can tell, these look drier. This hand looks drier. So it wasn't as moisturizing as I thought it would be, but it's moisturizing. There's the bottle again. Nice and velvety feeling. The cap. If you're familiar with the Clinique toner, it's the same cap. And you... Oh, I guess I already locked it. Open. Close. Not bad. No, it's definitely gentler on your hands than acetone is. You know, I like it. Definitely like it. I do believe that I will probably be buying the acetone from now on and just adding glycerin to it. You can buy glycerin at the drugstore. Just don't use it directly on your skin. You're not supposed to. I don't know why, but don't. So. Alright, comment, let me know what you think, what your experiences have been. I can't speak today. Tired. That might need a little patch up job. I think I broke it there. Ah, bummer. But still going strong. Thank you for watching.